Case 1. In this case, we will show when the country can make only exchange gain. There is no specialization gain because here we are considering the factors are not mobile at all. So one factor can work in only one sector. So in this case, the production possibilities curve, to be precise, there will be no existence of production possibilities curve. There will be only one production point. So country can produce x0 units of x and y0 units of y. In this case, if we reduce the production of x, the production of y will not increase because the factors which are engaged in x, they cannot produce in y. And similarly, if we reduce the production of y, the production of x will not increase. So in this case, we consider that this is the ordered equilibrium. This is the ordered equilibrium. So P indicates, the slope of P indicates the domestic price ratio of x and y. So we can write here, slope of P equals to Px by Py under ordered. So E0 is the equilibrium point. Now if we consider the trade starts and the international price ratio is given by Pi. So Pi equals to slope of Pi indicates minus of Pxi by Py. So post trade CPL will be given by the line straight line Pi, and new equilibrium point will be given as E1 on higher indifference curve I1. So in this case, the country makes gain only through exchanging in the international price ratio. In this case, the country will export Y and import X. So in this case, the production is completely rigid. So the country can make only the exchange gain. There is no specialization gain from trade. Now, the second case. If we consider that no substitutability between commodities, this can be case when the two commodities are, let us consider two commodities that X and Y are, they are complementary goods. So there is no substitutability between X and Y. So in this case, the commodity indifference curves will be L-shaped and there will be no chance of exchange gain. So let us consider that TT is the production possibilities curve, the standard production possibilities curve, and I0 is the commodity indifference curve. So slope of P indicates the autarkic price ratio. Now let us consider the country opens up and international terms of trade is given by the slope of Pi. So new equilibrium will be attained and the higher indifference curve I1. So after this is the post trade production point of the country, and this is the post trade consumption point of the country. The country produces OX0 of X Y0 of Y and consumes Y2 units of X and OX1 units of Y1 units of Y, OX1 units of X. So this will be the export of X and this will be the import of Y. So here the country makes entire gain from changing its production point, doing more specialization in commodity X. So the entire gain is called specialization gain. There is no existence of exchange gain.